Hey, I thought I'd go through a great song by George Harrison, All Things Must Pass. It's a pretty simple song, but like lots of great songs from the Beatles and many others, a simple progression of chords can really do something really pretty powerful. So that's what I'll go through, show you the chords, and then come back and show you a little bit of the embellishments. Pretend we've got some horns, and I'll throw a little electric guitar in and show you a little bit of the extra layers that get added to the mix. So the chords we're going to work with are really pretty straightforward. Might require a little bit of getting used to fingering some things that are unfamiliar, but not too hard. So basic, open E. Then this one, if you start by using your last three fingers, then you can slide your pinky up and then get your first finger, your index finger, on the A here. So what we've got is open E, A. Then we've got the F sharp, then we've got the A again, the B, and the E. Then we're going to slide that up again. So now we've got the B here, and we've got G sharp here, A and E, B and E. Up to an A. You can do the A that way, sort of a partial bar chord using your thumb, or you can do the A down here. And in fact, Harrison seems to alternate between those different kinds of A's. So when you play it along with it, mix it up, see which ones sound nice over, depending on which lyrics you're using. And those chords are the ones that make up the verses, the introduction, the ending, pretty much everything except for the chorus that we'll get to. So just a little bit worry about the nomenclature. So we've got our E here. When we slide up and play this, what we've got is the one, the E. We've got the two, which is the F sharp. We've got the four, which is the A. And we've got the B, which is the fifth. So we've got a chord that's got the one, the two, the four, and the fifth. If we had just a chord with the one, the two, and the fifth, we'd call that a E sus two. If we had a chord with the one, the fourth, and the fifth, that is, say, E, A, and B, we call that E sus four. But we've got them both, the two and the four. So we'll call it an E sus two sus four. What's important is for a suspension chord is the three drops out and gets replaced by either the two or the four. So instead of playing the G sharp, we play either the A or the F sharp. In this case, we're playing both. So then when we move up to this chord up here, we have an extra little twist, is that the G sharp is being played, so we do have the three, and the A is also being played. Now, you might think of that as kind of an E major add four, if you want. The result of this is you get this very nice walk up from an E, all the way up to an A. So here's how basically the progression goes. Now we get ourselves ready for the chorus, and it's just going to be B minor. All things must pass, A. Add the D for the sus 4. All things must pass away. So that E back up to that E sus 2 sus 4, back to the E. And then you can walk it back up again. Start the next verse. Thank you. So we're going to go through the verses like that. Then the one change we get is a little bit deeper into the song. So I'll go through that part now. Now, the only time we really break from that pattern of the progressions of the E and the B minor to the A, the sus4 back to the E, is when we get to all things must pass, just B minor A. None of life's strings can last, B minor A, so I must be on my way. Face another day, and then back into the verse immediately. Darkness so and then we're off and going again. Finally, last little bit before we start adding the different embellishments is the way he's got this nice little lick in there and this nice little riff that's really based off of the A and ends up on the E. So I'll show you that, and then we'll come back, put the acoustic track on, and then show you some of the stuff that you can do with a slide and electric guitar. Okay, so just a few moves that get made with different instruments, just to add a little bit more texture. When the song starts with its first progression, the horns come in with this little lick, starting off the E. So E down to D sharp, back up to E, and B. Then the second time around, slide up to the F sharp. When we get to the chorus, that is when the acoustic guitar is strumming the B minor and the A sus4. The electric sometimes just. And even, we'll do it sometimes 12 frets up. As we come out of the chorus, we'll often hear some high picking over those unusual E-shaped chords, what we were doing. So things like. And then finally, if you're handy with a slide, try moving it up from the 12th up another octave, both up and down. Pick your spots for the use of a slide, put the pieces together, got a very beautiful song. All right, hope that was of some use. Take it easy.